all re-energized and ready to get for another few sessions. So we'll start with another panel about our local ecosystem here in Cluj. I think that's going to be very exciting. So I'll let our host, who has been both in the US and the European ecosystem. So he is, as you can tell from his name, he's Romanian-American. So the first name is American, Mike, originally Mihai, as I learned. And the last name I had to practice pronouncing, Costache. So he's going to take you through this panel about our local ecosystem and give you a lot of advice on how we can grow and develop it. And I'll leave it in to him to announce the fabulous panel members and himself even more. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Give a hand to our panel, please.
Bună ziua tuturor. Everybody who wants a job should come back in here and leave all the networking outside. We're going to shorten this from 40 minutes to 30 minutes so you could get some nice lunch. Before I introduce a very distinguished list of four individuals, two who flew here from many, many miles ago to be here today, I'd like to say that Cluj is the only city besides Bucharest that I would actually consider living in if I lived full-time in Romania. I've been here maybe 10 times in my life and I always feel very welcome. So now I understand why these gentlemen here live here and invest here. You know, we started this great conference, the Vlad and Juana, and the big team of people have been working year-round to put it together by having the big vision, going to space. Then we had some amazing presentations about how to run $1 billion a month between people, which was pretty cool. Then how to make money in Germany or get investments from Germany through Samsung, which is interesting. Samsung hired a German guy to run their VC fund here. And then, of course, we had Mr. Asia. Where is Mr. Asia? You know, everybody should go to Asia. He's going to give everybody money to party, apparently, but we'll see how long the diligence is with him. And then here we are. Then we had some other German fellows talking about their VC fund. And now here we are talking about investments in Cluj, which is where most of you live, right? Most of you are from Cluj, or you want to move to Cluj, like me, maybe? All right. So I think we're competing with a panel upstairs, how to get funding. But what they don't know is that these gentlemen here have money. They invested. They're also advisors to some companies, but it's hard to reach them. So they're here to give a little bit of why they invested in Cluj. And possibly, if you're lucky and you have this amazing idea, that they, one day they'll be proud of saying, I went to Texylvania one time, and this young person came up to me, and they told me this idea, and I didn't get it, but then I became their advisor. Then I invested in them, and now I'm proud to say I'm a part of blah, blah company. So whatever great idea you have, pitch them, because they're here for a short period of time. So without further ado, I'll go to my notes, and I will introduce my party buddy for the last 2 days, Mr. Jerry Canelli, who has an impressive background. He's here all the way from Silicon Valley. He owns a company here, what's worldwide in many, many countries. It's called Riverbed Technologies. And when he purchased one of his many 10 companies he purchased in Germany, he acquired the division here, which was 9 people. Now it's 16 people, and it's growing. They have 2,400 employees. They do $1.1 billion in sales. And before he started this company many years ago, he was successfully running another great company called Inktomi. For some of you that may remember, Yahoo used to run on Inktomi until Google came in, and he told me a great story last night about that. And he's also a CPA by training. He started in finance. So sometimes I encourage everybody that's young to start in finance and then go into operations, then eventually run a billion-dollar company like him. Then we have Konrad Kaszek, who's running here at the famous Bosch plant for the last 4 years. They've made a $200 million investment so far, and they employ 2,500 people, which is pretty amazing. They're up to $400 million sales. And he comes from 30 years background as a physicist. He prides himself in having started as a physicist, but now he's a manager more than running physical things around. And they're trying to reach to $1 billion by 2022. And then we have Mr. Patrizio Mapelli, as he said to us in the conference room, who is mainly on planes, but he's proud to be from Milan originally. And for 25 years, he's been in IT consulting. And previously to joining as the CEO and president of NTT Data for this region, Europe and the Middle East, he was a CEO of a company called Value Team, and that was one of the 5 companies that was acquired to become NTT Data. And then we have our local famous deputy CEO of Banca Transilvania, the main sponsor and supporter of this conference. DB is not just a banker like most bankers. He actually prides himself in looking at the wider angle of socioeconomic changes, and he's a big supporter of SMEs, and as is the bank. That's why he works there for 14 years. And lately, he's been very busy launching BT MIC, which is the small Banca Transilvania, I guess, and he'll tell us more about that. So these are just a few things, but their full bios are on the mobile app that we have for the conference and, of course, on their LinkedIn's. So without further ado, I'm going to turn around and ask you, why did you invest in this wonderful city called Cluj, and what are the results that you're proud of mostly? Jerry?
Yeah, completely by accident. No, so we're an IT company. Of our 2,400 employees, 1,300 are technical people, and 9 of them are hardcore development engineers. And so we do development in 14 different locations around the globe, one in Asia, 4 different places in Europe, and 9 different places in the United States. And like you said, we'll do $1.1 billion US dollars in turnover this year at a 34% net profit rate. And the reason we're able to do that is because we sell intellectual property. Intellectual property is the output from the brains and the imagination of human beings. And specifically what we're looking for is high quality trained engineers. And that is the scarce resource on the planet Earth. And so in our business, you have to scour the entire planet, Asia, Middle East, Europe, and America, to get a sufficient number of trained, high quality engineers who can write code, conceive of new products, and take them to market. And so there's a shortage of those people. Everyone's looking for them. The fact that you're here means that you're in the right-hand side of the bell curve of intelligence and skill in the world for your ability to do these things, and we're happy to be in Cluj to find you and put you to work to make us mutually wealthy, because we're going to give you some stock.
Thank you, thank you.
Yeah. From our point of view, Bosch, we always are looking for growth and for places where we can grow. When I started in the company, we had just 18 billion German marks as a turnover. Today, we have 75 billion euros. So during the 30 years, we have had a huge growth, and this was only possible by going to different countries. And looking for growth potential in Europe, we screened several places and finally found the hidden diamond. This is Cluj. With very good educated people, a long history looking towards Europe. And we started our plant 4 years ago with zero. We now have 2,500 with the first stage, and we will have a second and a third stage of development here. So huge, Cluj is a strategic site for Bosch, and we will significantly grow further. Who wants to see this can go to Juku, where the construction for the second stage already started. but we are not looking only for employees in our plant. We also would like to inspire young startups, especially in the area of machine building and high automation. The future of Industry 4.0 and Internet of Things does not only need software engineers, they only need real mechanical engineers, mechatronics, and all those guys. So basically, I am here to just make a little bit advertisement to found such kind of companies. That means smart machine building companies that are able to support big manufacturing companies.
Before they're taken to China by some other people.
For example, we do this everywhere in China, in Mexico, just recently. And even in Germany, in Dresden, we announced that we will build a huge semiconductor plant in Dresden. This will be one of the very few semiconductor plants built in Europe during the last time.
Thank you, thank you.
Let me say a few words about NTT and NTT Data. NTT Data is a company that has about 17 billion turnover and 90,000 people. In Europe, we are about 2.5 billion revenues and 17,000 people. And NTT Data Romania is 1,500 people. Why we invested in Romania? Honest answer, when we decided to invest in Romania, we were thinking only at that time to have a nearshore, low-cost a delivery center for German market. What we have understood during the time is that Romania is much more than just a low-cost country. We found very capable people, very competent people, highly committed person, very, very, very committed person, very capable. So we completely changed our approach since the beginning. Beginning was we need low-cost. Right now we see Romania as a great opportunity to have inclusion in particular, to have highly competent people. And that is driving our intention also for the future. Just to move from, maybe because it's too far, just to move from, to have here an innovation center, we have decided to invest in robotics here in Cluj, to hire some people dedicated to develop robotic solution, artificial intelligence and robotics for the rest of Europe. So the decision has changed since the beginning from a pure cost center, low cost country to a highly, highly developed solution for the entire Europe.
Let's use that one.
Thank you, Mike. I hope that the mic is working this time. So for us, it's quite simple and straightforward. We were born in Cluj, so investing in Cluj was actually kind of natural to us. And if you look at Banca Transilvania, well, we used to be this 15 years ago or 20 years ago, we used to be this regional, rather solitary bank. And now we have developed into the organization that you know today, that needs to and wants to open up and build here in Cluj its new platforms, its new digital platforms. So from that perspective, we're very much interested to have an ecosystem with lots of vendor partners and lots of companies that will help us build further and digitalize the entire organization. And we're ready from that perspective to invest on a yearly basis to have from this investment item to be the largest investment item on our yearly budget, the investment in digitalization and new technologies, and we would very much like to be the catalyst of such an ecosystem here in Cluj-Napoca.
So people from the audience that are either looking for a job in your companies, they know how to apply or they reach out to you. But those who have some great technology and they would like to sell it to you, right? Sometimes they would come to you and you would say, I'd rather hire you, and then turning you into an intrapreneur, so to speak, right? So how do you deal with that when you find, you know, from a conference or from some other way, somebody comes to you with a great technology that you could see putting it through your distribution channel, of course, after the proper R&D is done. How do you deal with that kind of, because I think some people here came to meet with you to possibly pitch you on a great technology that could be sold through your company's distribution channels, or to partner with you, not necessarily to sell it to you. Well, you're going to finance them, and then they will come.
I have the mic. So this is very much changing. Banks, including Banca Transilvania, used to be this, and we still are these hierarchical organizations where working within a bank would mean complying with a certain rules and certain criteria, so it wouldn't be that you would call it, it's not such a fun activity. Well, this is changing very fast, and this is changing in Banca Transilvania as well. So we're now deploying a large number of people into a separate hub, for example, the ones dealing with new technologies and new ideas and digitalizations, and also the atmosphere and the new forms of banking are changing equally. So I would say that in the next couple of years, you will see banks being as active in technology just like any other technology company, and working within a bank would no longer mean just working on a lending activities or working at the front desk or the types of activities that are typically associated with banking. So I'm really optimistic. Mindsets and the organizations are changing, and banking is going to follow and is going maybe to even set the trend in the future in terms of the way people will get inside.
Thank you.
Let me answer in a little broader way. As I said before, we have decided to invest and to make Cluj an R&D center, mainly for robotics and artificial intelligence applied to robotics. That's because of the capabilities, the skill that we have already have in Cluj. The broader answer is, we, as a strategy to grow, it's to do an acquisition. We acquire the company here, and then we have the leadership team, Daniel and all the leadership team, they have a full autonomy to drive the business in Romania. So that means that the leadership team of Entity Data Romania can decide if they want to go further to evaluate opportunities to acquire or to partner with some organization. So if there is any new ideas like the one that they found regarding robotics to collaborate, we can decide to fund. We have also decided to send people here in Cluj from Tokyo, from R&D department in Tokyo, to send a manager here to lead this innovation up. And through this way, if there are ideas, that's really welcome. And it's, as a Japanese company, we are very keen about innovation. Sometimes innovation is too broad, too vague, but we are very keen to identify good ideas that can be applied to the business. So if there is any good idea, let's talk to the Entity Data Romania and we will find a way to collaborate.
As I explained already in my introduction, meanwhile, in Romania, there are several huge manufacturing organizations. I just recently was, for example, at Dacia in Pitești. But if you go here to the area of Transylvania, you have a lot of manufacturing companies in Temeswar, in Sibiu, in Brasov, and meanwhile, also in Cluj. And these manufacturing companies need high sophisticated support from local companies. This is a real good opportunity to found startups. If you look, for example, for the success of Germany, especially in the southern areas, very many small companies have been founded supporting Daimler-Benz, supporting Bosch, supporting Audi, BMW, and other big manufacturing companies. And we have the opinion that meanwhile, we have been reaching a size of manufacturing sites here that are really waiting for such kind of medium-sized startups that are focusing on robotic services, on machine building, on special machine construction, and so on. It is not only software that is offering the opportunity to make a startup. Especially in Romania, where the universities are very strong and also the mechanical part of the universities or the electronic part of the university is very strong. There's big potential now to found small companies that are supporting the big manufacturing sites. Otherwise, if it is not supplied locally, then we have to get it from Germany or from Switzerland or from elsewhere. We are really willing to buy from local companies that are just focusing. And the future of Internet of Things, the future of the connected world, they just need mechatronic people who are able to serve the robots. Otherwise, robots will just simply fail and the manufacturing will stop. My message basically is don't only focus on software, but also start to use creativity in the area of engineering, robotics engineering, mechatronics, and all electronics and digital electronics.
Go ahead. Yes, so we are very active acquirers of interesting technologies, and I think I've bought 14 companies so far, and our presence in Cluj is because we did buy a company with a local presence, and in the technology world, it really comes down to make or buy. You have to make a decision, and the reason we will buy rather than make it ourselves is usually time to market, because the product cycles are very short in technology. You know, if you If you run a steel mill, you know, in 2017, you're probably selling the same grade steel that you developed in 1931, right? But if you're selling technology to big companies, the thing you developed in 2015 may already be obsolete, or it may be missing or deficient features it needs in the new world of cloud computing and work 4.0. So we're always on the lookout. What we like to buy is something that has some size already, is industrial grade, which means, you know, we sell to the largest networks in the world, the largest companies in the world, the largest government networks in the world, and there, it has to work. It has to be bulletproof. You can't take down, you know, the network of a large airline or the network or a big government network by selling immature technology. So, time to market, improving our product offering with the latest features, and if the company has already acquired a few good name customers, that's a bonus to us. And something that integrates into our general strategy and vision and plan going forward. So I have a backpack full of cash here, so if anyone has one of these, you know, please see me after the meeting. So.
And now I have a question about education and about your vision of, so some people here that skipped college to be here today, yes? Who didn't go to classes today to be here? Did anybody skip school? No? All right, so everybody's out of school. So the question is this, a lot of people want to be entrepreneurs. They want to raise money, build their own companies, and here they are looking at four distinguished executives in very, very large companies, and most of you have been part of startups, advised startups. Do you still recommend for most young people to first get their feet wet in a big company and kind of find a mentor there to survive with, or do you recommend that they go start a company and then figure out if they're made to be entrepreneurs and then come into the corporate world? And then also, how do you see advanced degrees, not in sciences, of course, where they're really required, but in business, MBAs, would you advance somebody, or is there still a deterrent today where every piece of knowledge is accessible freely? Do you still require MBAs to go up the ladder to be as close to the chairman's office as possible?
I'd say that there's no correct answer to that question. It depends
on the trick question.
Yeah. So in general, I think if depends what your goal is. If your goal is to come out of the university or as a university student have some, you already have some clever little thing that you want to move, and but you don't really aren't set to build a big scaled company over time, and you don't, you know, necessarily want to be the CEO. But just want to get it going, then you could do it. I think if you have longer term ambitions to make something that could be a billion-dollar company like Bosch or NTT, then it's very good discipline to work in a large company as a young person and see how business works, see the different functions of business, develop some disciplines, develop some contacts, learn how to operate in a business world, not in a student world. And then also get a salary and pay your rent and pay your tuition and have some financial resources to hold you up, because once you do go into the startup world, the failure rate is over 90%. So you have to be a person who has some tolerance for that risk.
Thank you.
I see it a little bit in the same way like my colleague here to the right side. So without any experience about the expectations of a customer, what the customer is really looking for and how the markets are, it is very difficult to be successful just having an idea. And having a certain experience from working in a company, it helps, but it's also a personal topic. So you need to have the personality to run a company, and not just only focusing on the technology, but you have to just understand the financial elements, especially when you hire people. Then suddenly the business gets very expensive very fast, so you need to be able to pay the people, otherwise your company will just be blown away. But if you really want to make it, then you can start also with smaller ideas, basing and not just start the big shot to be a billionaire soon. You can also run a self-owned business which has a smaller size, as an engineering office, for example, or an educational office. Here in Romania, for example, we have a lot of lacks in the education, especially in the area of what is called vocational. In principle, we don't have any craftsmen here in Romania anymore. And if you want to run a robot-based manufacturing plant, then you need a lot of mechatronics technicians and so on, because engineers will not go to three-shift work. There's a lot of opportunities to start with smaller businesses, with service companies and so on. And if you have big customers who are paying straightforward and not hesitating to pay, then you can develop the company. This is how in the northern parts of Italy, in the south of Germany, in the United States, and in especially also in England, very successful companies have been founded, by just finding the right customer and being a reliable supplier to these customers.
And just a quick question. So far, the company has invested 200 million here in Cluj, and now you're doing about 400 million 4 years later in revenue.
Yeah, we are building.
Not bad.
We are building now the second building, and this building has to be equipped. It will be equipped with high automation equipment. We have a lot of robots in our plant. So currently we do on our own, and we bring the services from Germany in most cases. So we would like to buy it here, but here the companies are missing who can support in this way. So if the Banca Transilvania is just willing to just set up such kind of companies, then the customers are there.
Thank you. I agree. I don't think there is a right or wrong answer. It depends a lot on the attitude of the person, of the what the people believe, what the person believe. Obviously, a solid cultural background is fundamental. It's key for everything. But then being part of a large corporation or start being an entrepreneur, I think is a matter of the people. Personally, with the current environment here in Romania, if I would have a good idea, I will try to do by my own. I will try to be an entrepreneur, to maybe to ask support, but to develop my own idea by my own. I have seen so many bright persons, so many motivated people, that I will really follow this way. Always we have time, we have possibility to move from our own small entrepreneurial initiative into a large corporation. But being young, being capable, having the possibility, as it is here in Romania, to start my own company, I will do like that. I will really try to start my own initiative, to find a way to do by my own.
Thank you. That's what I wanted to hear.
Well, I seen it played both ways. I've seen wonderful surprises, both from people that never had a job in their lives and they just started up, or from people that worked for 5 or 10 years in big companies and then just they went on their own. And we've seen it the other way around. So basically, there's no clear cut to this. However, what I've seen lately, especially in the past couple of years in Romania, happening within the startup movement, is that people tend to more easily than in the past associate in teams or two or three people, and they complement skills. And you've got maybe this outgoing person, this creative person that will be able to just push the business or the idea further, which is being team up with this more disciplined guy that knows a bit about financials and knows a bit about, you know, getting their feet on the ground so that their aspirations are not far beyond their pockets. Obviously, it depends also about the skin in the game, that the equity or the capital, the money that you have, and the ones willing to support it. So really, in our case, I think most of us are more like company men, organizational type of, so we maybe believe that a bit of discipline, a bit of knowledge, a foundation, a basis would be the basis for better chances in the future. Actually, I really don't know, and I have asked this question many times over, and I have seriously asked that question myself, whether I would be willing or able to do something like that. And the more the time goes, I think that the less the chances are that I really do it. So I just say that whomever has got the guts and some equity, that will always help. And then a partner that would balance him the right way, then he should just do it. He or she should just do it.
Great. Thank you for your advice. Unfortunately, since we want to let you go eat, we're going to cut it by 10 minutes. Like I mentioned, I have 35 seconds on the clock. So I want to respect the organizers' time. Again, Vlad and Juana and the whole team and Philip, this is an amazing conference. I've heard about this for many years. And I remember Vlad having lunch with me 7 years ago in Bucharest, talking about being stuck in a bigger company, working with Philip later. And he was looking to do something greater for a lot of people. And eventually he started this company, Techsylvania. And now he's doing so many more conferences in Germany. So I want to congratulate them. And that's one person that you should get to know, because he now knows everyone and everyone knows him. So with that, I will allow Philip to come and kind of cut us off and let you all go get some nice lunch. Thank you.
Thank you very much. But the guys are not getting lunch yet. So there's still two more presentations before lunch. But we're getting closer to lunch. There's like still another 40 minutes to go to lunch. So we'll like really like take them hardcore, as they are all filled with coffee now. Let's take them. Thank you very much, all of you, for coming. It was like a great pleasure having you in here. And thank you for the support. Jerry, you're not going anywhere.
I'll be back in a second.
So thank you very much, Mike, for